Hi everyone, I'm Remy Lai and I'm an author and illustrator. And today I'm going to be talking a little bit, well not a little bit, a lot about my graphic novel Pawcasso here. And it's a graphic novel, so you can look at the inside there. So I wrote the story and I did all the drawings. We actually have a colorist who did all the colors inside the book as well as on the cover. And if you look at the dog there on the cover, well, he looks very similar to the dog next to me here. There you go. Let's see if he'll put his head up. There you go. And that's because this book is really inspired by my dog. And I'm going to do a little bit of drawing later and you can draw along. So if you want to get your paper and pencil or pen ready, that would be great. So I actually live in Australia, which is really far away from you. The story in Pawcasso here, it doesn't really say where it's set, but if you look really closely, you can see that the people drive on the left side of the road, which is really different from where you are. So let's go ahead here. Now I'm going to tell you a little bit about what Pawcasso is about, and I'm going to use drawings to show that. So you don't have to draw along for this one because it's going to be pretty quick. So, okay, let's go. So the book's title is Pawcasso. And that is actually a play on the name of the famous painter, Picasso. So there you go. But because it's about a dog, so we call it Pawcasso, like the paw of a dog. So there you go. And so Pawcasso, the book has two main characters, a human and the dog Pawcasso. So the human is actually a girl who is 11 years old, and I'm drawing her right now. You don't have to follow this one because I'm going to show you a step-by-step and slower drawing later on how to draw Jo. So she's 11 and her name is Jo, and she has friends in school, but she doesn't have any that she hangs out with outside of school. So when summer vacation comes around, she is pretty lonely and also really, really bored, because she has no one to play with. And so she spends a lot of her time sitting by the window of her house, looking really bored. And so that's here. And if you look at the book, you'll find that she's always wearing the same thing. Well, not the same thing, but she's always wearing overalls and t-shirts. And she just has, she has many of them in different colors. So there she goes. So let's have Jo walking here. So one day while Jo is sitting at the window of her house staring out, she sees something that makes her go, wow. And that's actually a dog. And this dog here, I'm going to draw him here. So there you go. Here, it's a dog. So she doesn't know this dog. This is the first time she's seeing this dog. And this dog is on his own, and this dog is walking past her house, and there you go. He has a long fluffy tail, and he's walking alone, and so there are no owners nearby, and let's see, let's draw. He has kind of like a fluffy kind of feathers here. Let's draw his legs. There. And the most interesting thing about this dog is that it's actually carrying a basket. So let's draw the basket here. So this is not something that you see every day. So Jo is super curious about this dog. And she's thinking, okay, where is this dog going? And where is the owner? And what is inside that basket? And so that's the basket here. So Jo actually, she follows the dog and she finds out that inside this basket here, there is actually a grocery list or a shopping list. So let's see, shopping list. And then it lists the items that, you know, you want to buy. So whatever, maybe like butter or something, or milk or something like that. And then, so it's inside this basket. And there's also some cash inside this basket. So let's draw some money. And it's inside this basket. And so Jo follows the dog, and the dog actually goes to a shopping circle, which has many stores. And so the dog can actually open doors. So he would go into a store, and then inside this store, the shopkeeper would help the dog to shop using the shopping list that is inside the basket. So let's move on to a new one. So then let's draw the basket again. So for example, if on that day, maybe on the shopping list, there is, they want to get a carrot. So let's do a carrot here. And then, or a bag of chips. There, chips there. Or a bottle maybe of milk there. And then the shopkeeper would also place the change back inside the basket. So maybe some coins or some paper money. And then the dog would pick up this basket again and then go to the next store and the next store and the next store. And one of the shops that the dog goes into is actually an ice cream shop. So he doesn't buy ice cream because by the time he goes home, it would be melted. But the storekeeper gives him some free ice cream samples. But the last store that the dog goes into is actually a bookstore. And this bookstore, so it sells books. And this bookstore is called Dog Ears. So the name comes from, like, if let's say you have a book that you read a lot or it's an old book, sometimes the edges of the corners of the book gets folded in kind of like a dog's ear. You know how sometimes a dog's ear looks like that, folded in that way. This is a dog. So this bookstore is called Dog Ears. And in Dog Ears, Jo and the dog meets a group of kids. So this is one of them. His name is Kane here. And this group of kids, they are actually having an art class inside the store. So let's see, art class. So let's say a canvas. An easel, oops, and then maybe he is holding a paintbrush like that. And so some of these kids in the art class are from Jo's school. So she knows some of them and they know her. So when they see her, they say, "Hey, Jo, I didn't know you have a dog, Jo." Because they see her with a dog and they assume that the dog is hers, but it's not. But because Jo, she wants to make new friends, she wants someone to hang out with during the summer vacation, she doesn't try very hard to tell them that the dog is not hers. So she just lets them think that the dog is hers. So when they ask her, "What is your dog's name?" she has to make up a name on the spot because she has no idea what this dog's name is. So let's see her here. So this is her. Oops, wrong nose. Let's see. And what do you think she says the dog's name is? That's right. She says the dog's name is Pawcasso. because she's thinking that these kids are trying to paint like Picasso, the painter. So, but because the dog, so let's call him Pawcasso. And so as the story goes on, sometimes the other kids would ask her, "Hey, Joe, what, how old is your dog? How old is Pawcasso?" She has no idea. So she would have to say, maybe 4. Or sometimes they ask her, "Does Pawcasso like to fetch?" She would have to lie and say, "Yeah," but she really has no idea. So here she is being nervous as she tells more and more lies. And then the dog becomes more and more famous in this town because he is a shopping dog, right? And so Joe has to tell more lies and bigger lies. And then there's a higher chance that everyone will find out because now the dog is famous. They will find out that the dog is not hers. So so Joe is spends a lot of the story being really nervous. So this is this nervous face is a face that you'll find, you'll see a lot inside the book. So it's a story that's about friendship. It's obviously about dogs also, but it's also really about, later on, it would become about forgiveness and acceptance and trying to see another person's point of view. But I won't go into that because I won't spoil that for you. Right now, I'm going to do some drawing again, but this time I'm going to do it slower and step by step so that you can follow. So if you want to get your paper and pen ready, now is the chance while I create another canvas. So there you go. So I'm going to draw Joe first. What I'm going to do is I'm going to draw just her head. What I'm going to do is first, I'll draw like a curve in and out, a slight curve this way. That's the side of her face. So this, and then from the bottom of this wave, I'll draw a curve going a little bit upward. So that's the side of her face. And then, and that curve is the bottom of her head, her chin. And now I'm going to show you a trick for drawing ears. So what I do is I write the letter C, like A, B, C, like that. And then inside that C, I would write the number 6. And there you get an ear. And then for the other ear, you just flip the C and the 6 over. But in this case, you can't really see all of the C and the 6 on this side because her face is covering it. And then now I'm going to show you how to draw her hair. So she has a little bit to the right here because that's where her hair parts. So we draw a curve down, but not all the way. And then we draw a short curve up that way. And then we do another curve down to the corner of that left ear there. Are you ready? Okay, now let's do the other side of her fringe here. So we go back to where the hair parts and then we just go and connect it to the other corner of her ear there. And then there's this line here that we can erase a little bit if you want to. And then Joe has a cowlick. That's where your hair at the top of your head doesn't really stay flat. So I'm sure some of you would have that. So at the top here, I would draw like a tuft of grass. So that's what we call a cowlick. And then I'm going to draw the front of her head. So I would draw a big curve. But when I go in, I go out again because her hair is a little bit messy. So we're going to have her hair sticking out in a few different directions. So once we have that, we are trying to go back to her head here, but we have to do it in like little jagged curve lines because her hair is messy. So now we have the front of her face, her head, and let's do the back of her head. We just go back to the cowlick here, draw a curve down, out, out here again, jagged curves, and then connected to the back of her head. So now we have her head. And for her nose, we do it a little bit to the right because that's where she's facing. So we draw a short curve here. A short line. And then a curve here, like a C that you flip over. And her eyes, watch what happens. They're really simple. They're just ovals like that. That's Joe. And now let's give her an expression. So let's say I want to give her a smile like that. Something is missing from this face, and that is her eyebrows. So this is her happy face, her happy face. But watch what happens if I give her these eyebrows. So that makes her mischievous or evil. And you can see how the expression immediately changes just by doing little tweaks to the face. And let's say I want to make her more evil. What I could do is I could open up her mouth here, and let's give her some teeth. What kind of teeth do you think looks more evil? I think sharp teeth. So let's do it this way. You don't have to make your Joe evil, but you could. And then another thing that I could do is maybe I could make her eyebrows thicker and join them up this way. That's a really evil Joe. One last one is just to draw one circle around her eye and another one here. So that's a really evil Joe. And then you can have her, let's give her something to say. What would evil Joe say? Maybe she would say, ha, you know, like, ha, gotcha. And then you can draw what we call a speech bubble here, pointing back to her because she's the one who is saying, ha. You can have her say whatever you want. And now I'm going to show you how to draw a simple version of the dog Pawcasso. Okay, I'm going to draw his whole body. So I'm going to draw him sitting up. So make sure to leave some space. So I'll start the top here. I will start by drawing the top of his head. So I would draw like a curve. That's the top of his head. And then I'm going to draw a smaller, shorter curve this way. And another short, small curve on the other side, like that. And I'm going to show you here. So Pawcasso has fur. The fur on his ears are kind of wavy. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw under that short curve, I'm going to draw three squiggly lines just under that short curve. And we give him three more squiggly lines for the other ear. There you go. And now we finish off the head by drawing another curve here. It's a little bit lopsided. There you go. And then if you look at his nose there, he has like a big pink nose. And so what I like to do is I like to draw his nose as a heart shape here. And for his eyes, I'm going to do a pretty similar thing to Joe. I'm just going to give him ovals for his eyes that way. And let's see this again. So he has two brown patches on his head. So I'm going to give him that. So I would start from the top of his head here. I'm going to draw a curve under his eye. And then another one on the other side. How's your Pawcasso head going? Now we're going to do his body. He's going to be sitting up. So from the right side here, a little bit to the back here, I'm going to draw a big curve for his back. And then I'm going to draw his hind leg. So from about the middle of this, of his back, I would draw a curve, but I would curve it the other way, the opposite way, that way. And then I'm going to draw his foot. So what I would do is I would draw kind of like a little sausage here, and I'll join it to that, the back. So that's his hind leg there. And then I'm going to draw his front leg. So I would draw a short, a straight line down, and then a little like curve for his paw that way. And then I'll finish that off with the line that way. And he has some brown patches on his back, so I would draw like a curved line like that. And if you look again at the cover here, he has a long fluffy tail. So let's give this Pawcasso, your Pawcasso, a long fluffy tail. So you can curve his tail whichever way you have space. I might curve him, curve his tail down this way. So you draw a big curve. And how would you draw a fluffy tail? Kind of similar to like a messy, Joe's messy hair. So like curved jagged lines like that. You can curve it whichever way you want. So there you go. Now you have Pawcasso, a simple version of Pawcasso. I wish I could see your Pawcasso. I'm sure they're all super awesome. And next, I'm going to show you how to draw yourself or other people as cartoon characters. So let's see here. Let's go to the next one. So I'm going to use me as an example. So I'm going to use really simple shapes to draw the face. So for example, for me, I like to use like a circle or a round shape for my head. So let's see. I'm going to do a round face here, but you can use other shapes. For example, maybe you have a square head or maybe you have like a more V-shaped kind of head or maybe an oval, like a U-shaped that way. So you can do whatever shape you think your head is. And then now you could use the trick that I showed you earlier for drawing ears to give yourself ears. So I would draw the C and the six. So you don't have to draw all these four faces. You could if you want to, but you can just pick one. So I'm going to draw all the ears here. Okay, now we're going to give me a nose. So you can do different shapes for nose too. So for example, you could do like the way I did it for Joe, which is a C that way. Or you could do it maybe more like a triangle or a sharp nose that way. Or you could have like a pointy nose. That's this way. It's kind of like a U that's lying on its side. And for me, I think I'm going to do something that's like the letter C, like Joe's nose, but maybe the C is lying on its side like that. So that's how I like to draw my nose. And for eyes, you can also use different shapes. I keep saying it wrong. And so you can use ovals like Joe's and Pawcasso's eyes, or you can use dots. I'm going to give myself dots for eyes here. Or you can draw like an oval this way. Another oval this way. And then you have to give yourself some pupils. So around pupils. And then you could also do oval eyes, but the other way. So the oval is upright this way. And then you have to give yourself pupils. I'm going to use ovals here. So you can see different eyes. So for me, I wear glasses. I'm going to give myself glasses. I like to just give myself this really thick round glasses like that. Okay. So now let's get on to hair. So I like to think first about where the hair, your hair parts. So for me, this my hair parts a little bit to the left. So I'm going to draw my fringe this way. And let's see. And then my ponytail is to the side here. So I think it's the other side, but okay. The camera is confusing me, but I'll just draw it on this way. And then my scrunchie and then my hair here. What other kinds of hair can you draw? Let's say you have curly hair. You could do something like a cloud shape here. Or maybe you have wavy hair. You could do your long wavy hair. Or maybe you have like a messy kind of fringe like that. And let's give him a cowlick here like that. Awesome. And now let's give these characters an expression. So I'm going to make me mad. So let's give me really angry eyebrows. And so remember how Joe here, I think here. So remember how as she's being evil, her mouth is in the shape like a smile. But if I want to make myself mad, I should probably make my mouth go the other way, like a frown, but with my mouth open and then teeth. So that makes me mad. And then so for the next one, let's make him sad. So I would do the eyebrows this way. Oh no, it's so sad. And I could give him frown. Or if I want to make him sadder, I could give him tears that way. And what other expressions could we have? So let's say happy. We haven't done happy. So let's make this one happy. So I would give a smile. Maybe to make him even happier, I could open up his mouth this way and give him some teeth. This is how I like to draw my teeth. And then what kind of eyebrows do you think look happy? I think like a curve like that looks happy. So yeah, they look pretty happy. And what about the last one? What kind of expression? Maybe make him nervous. So how do you make nervous? Or no, I think I'm going to do something where the eyebrows are kind of going in different directions. And then maybe you can tell me what kind of expression that is. So I'm going to give him one straight eyebrow and then the other eyebrow is curved like that. So what kind of expression is that? I think maybe he looks like he doesn't really believe in what you're saying. Like, really? I'm not sure. Or something like that. And then let's give him a mouth like, Like, he looks like he really doesn't believe in what you're saying. So you can see there how we can really change expression just by playing around with the eyebrows, the mouth, and the eyes. And so I would like you to try drawing yourself using these simple shapes, and you can draw your friends or your family members too, and then give them different kinds of expressions. And then you can also add the speech balloons, like Jo here, and she's saying, ha. You can make your character say different things. So for example, angry here, we could say roar. What about sad? What would they say? Maybe they would say, they would be crying. They would say sob. And happy, maybe would, what would happy people say? Maybe hooray, hooray. And then last one, maybe he's saying, yeah, right. He looks like that's what he's saying. Yeah, right. Like he doesn't believe in what you're saying. Yeah, so try and do this activity on your own and see what you can come up with. So one last thing before we go. I'm just going to show you a little bit some things from the book. So remember how I said that one of the stores that Pawcasso goes into is an ice cream shop. So ice cream is really important to Pawcasso because he loves ice cream. And so at the back of the book, I included this recipe here for ice cream that can be eaten by both dogs and people. So if you read this book, maybe you can try the recipe. And also, I think I'll let you meet my dog, who is the inspiration behind Pawcasso. There he's sleeping. But if you want to take a look at him again, you can. If you get a chance to look at the book, you can actually find a picture of him at the back here. So that is his picture. That is him after he had a bath, after he rolled in some poop. Yeah. There's some poop rolling going on in this book. So I hope that you had a great time. I know I did. And yeah, thank you for joining me. Thanks. Bye.